गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ आवर नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर फेडरलिज्म फॉर क्लास 10। एज इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ फेडरलिज्म, देन वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द की फीचर्स ऑफ द फेडरलिज्म, एंड देन दैट व्हाट इज़ द रीज़न दैट वी कॉल इंडिया एज अ फेडरल नेशन। वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट इट इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर, एंड देन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट हाउ द फेडरलिज्म प्रैक्टिस्ड इन इंडिया। Then we have talked about the various types of policy which makes India a federal country. There is a language policy, then the relationship between center and the state government. And then we have talked about the decentralization in India, and we have discussed it in a detail. Then we have done certain NCERT question beta. As in the chapter, NCERT question has not completed. So in this, you can say in this video, I'm going to explain you the remaining NCERT questions, and also I will give you the same question as your homework. So question number 9 up to the question number 8 we have done as a homework. We have discussed it also. So question number 9 is of the same chapter, that a few subjects in various list of the Indian Constitution are given here. Group them under the Union, State, Concurrent list and as provided in the table below. So it is very necessary that in this video I especially explaining you that what is the format of the NCERT question, how you have to do these question. As when we say objective type question, that you only think that true false statement and fill ups and yes no questions, and but here in NCERT pattern you must be knowing that what is the pattern of the question and how you will answer this particular question. So in this question, here certain ABC point has given, and these are the different subjects as defense, then B police, then agriculture, then education, then banking, forest, communication, trade and marriages. These are the different subjects, and we know that these different subjects has you can say governed by the Union list or the concurrent list or the state list. And here you have to draw like this diagram, and you have to write down the question first, then you have to make this diagram Union list, then state list and concurrent list, and you have to identify that what particular subject come under Union list, as defense come under Union list, then what are the other you can say subject which come under the Union list. Whatever subject will come under the Union list, you have to write down in front of Union list. These are the subjects, what are the subject. Then state list, what are the subject which you find that forest, communication, trade, among them which are subject which come under the state list. Then concurrent list, as a marriage come under the marriage, the subject which come under the concurrent list, or other also as we have discussed it in a detail in the previous video. So here I am particularly giving you the pattern and the idea that how you have to do this question, because many time it happens student couldn't understand the pattern of the question, and then that's why they are not giving the answer in a correct manner or in a correct form or format. So the question number 9 up to the question number 8 we have done when we covered the fourth part of the same chapter. Now in this video I am discussing the remaining question of the NCERT of the same chapter, and then in next video we will start a new chapter. So from question 9 you will do like this. Then question number 10 in the same chapter, examine the following pairs that give the level of the government in India and the powers of the government at the level to make laws on the subjects mentioned against each. Which of the following pair is not correctly matched? So here one side as a matchup question they have given the name of the category of the government, state government, central government, then central and state governments, and then last local government. And here are the list, that state list, then union list, then concurrent list and residuary powers. So which match up, which statement is not matched correctly, you have to identify. And how you will do this, that first of all you will note down the question completely, then you will make the same graph, and then you have to answer that among them which pair is not correct. As state government will deal with the state list, correct, central government definitely, union list will come under the central government, is central and state government, then definitely there are some subjects which come under the concurrent list, and these subjects are in a united form. Central and state government both are having their powers on the subject which come under the concurrent list. It is also correct. So local, when we say local government, so local government is not you can say residuary powers is not come under the local government. So this D portion is incorrect. So in the such a manner you have to write down the answer, that in this matchup the option number D is not correct, as residuary powers not come under the local government. So after noting down the question, then this improper matchup you have to write down the which pair is wrong. Now question number 11, match list 1 with list 2 and select the correct answer using the codes given below the list. Here are two lists, list 1 and list 2. You have to match up both lists, and then you have to match your list with these code, that which code is correct. Earlier you have only done the, you can say match up, that okay, this is correct, it is not a proper match up. But here the one thing also added, that after matching this list 1 with list 2, you have to match with these option. Option A is correct, or B, or C, or D. So here you have to do more, do the things in a more attentive manner. It is not a simple you can say match up question. Here you have to match the code also. Union list of India in list 2nd, Prime Minister. State, Sarpanch. Municipal corporation, governor. Gram panchayat, mayor. You know, all are incorrect. So now you have to first do the correct matchup, as Union list of India is related to the Prime Minister. Yes, state is related to the governor, municipal corporation is related to the mayor, and gram panchayat is related to the sarpanch. Now you have to match that which code is correct among A, B, C, D, and then you have to make a correct tick which option will be correct. So first of all you have to match the column in a rough notebook in a proper way, then you have to match the code also. Now question number 12, and it is the last question, which is based on the NCERT folder. Consider the following two statements in a federation. The powers of the federal and the provincial government are clearly demarcated. B, India is a federation because the powers of the union and state governments are specified in the constitution and they have exclusive jurisdiction on their respective subjects. C, Sri Lanka is a federation because the country is divided into provinces. D, India is no longer a federation because some powers of the states have been devolved to the local government's bodies. Which of the statements given above are correct? Here A, B, C, D. Four statement has given towards the federal system of government, and you have to identify that among these A, B, C statement, which statements given above are correct. How many statements are correct when we say federal system of government? Options given A, B, and C, A, C, and D, then option C, A and B only, or option D, B and C only. So first of all you have to understand that what is the meaning of these statements. In a federation, the powers of the federal and provincial government are clearly demarcated. Yes, it is true. India is a federation because the powers of the union and state government is specified in the constitution and they have exclusive jurisdiction on their respective subjects. Yes, so A, B is in the favor of democracy, or you can say federal system of government. Now you have to identify C or D are also in the favor of federal system of government or not. Then you have to select which option will be the correct answer. Now this is all about your NCERT folder question. Now you can also there is a great need that when we say that how in board examination the question will be asked, so in the middle of the chapter the question can be asked to you, as it can be asked that write any major steps which has been taken by the Indian government for the adaptation of the third tier of the government, that how they implemented. So these steps, it can be asked any three. You have to, at least you have to learn four steps. What are the four? How the third tier system of the government has implemented in India after 1992. These are the things that which we hadn't completed earlier. Now the another thing that as you can understand that these are the some important key definition. What is jurisdiction? As you can see that a jurisdiction, the area over which someone has legal authority is known as jurisdiction. The area may be defined in terms of geographical boundaries or in terms of the certain kind of subjects. Jurisdiction meaning that it is a particular area where one is having a legal authority, or the area which may be defined in terms of geographical boundaries or in terms of certain kinds of subjects. So this is known as a jurisdiction. So there is a need to understand and now the question in a new pattern that the different types of caricature also has given. As you can see in this caricature, there is a huge man, and we here are two cartoons showing the relationship between center and states. Now you can see two cartoon, that one is a big cartoon, and then in each hole there is a certain different cartoons. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. In these big holes there are different faces, and this is a big face. So big faces represent the central government, and then the small faces are represent the state governments. So here are two cartoons showing the relationship between center and the states. Should the state go to the center with a begging bowl? How can the leader of a coalition keep the partners of government satisfied? So this caricature especially belong to the coalition government. As we say that in the election, if not a single political party win the election as a majority, independent, individually as a majority, so then the coalition government has formed. So by this caricature, it has been shown that when the coalition government has formed, then how the major party satisfy or the major party is capable to satisfy the other people who join the you can say same political party as a coalition government formation. So this caricature, that is it right that when in a coalition government the other smaller party always beg something in front of the major political party? Or how can the leader of a coalition party, as this big figure is represent the leader of the coalition party, how the leader of the coalition party keep the partners of the government satisfied? How, what are the steps that he can or the major political party can achieve to satisfy these small political leaders who help to form a coalition political party in a nation? So through this caricature in examination, different caricature can be given to you, and you have to identify that what subject and what you have observed in the particular caricature. This is also added as a question in the board also and in the home examination also for class 10. Now you can see, as this is the states plead for more powers, that you can see the powers and the state, that these two figure represent the state representative and how much power they are having. And these caricature cartoons show that they are begging and they are having empty you can say pots, as these are also political leader, but the main power is under these state political parties. And how the other political members are begging, they are asking some help, either the financial or the other type of help, to the main political figures. So is it a true democracy or the federal system when we are saying that equal power sharing should be there in a federal system of government? So this caricature reflects that there is not a federalism and there is not a equal power sharing which can support the federal system of government. So through the caricature, the various type of question can be asked to you. So it is very important that either the history or the civics or the economics, whatever caricature has been given to you, you have to read them, understand them. That doesn't mean that you will just enjoy these caricature, because these caricature is so, you can say, meaningful, and they are related to your subject, and they can be asked in your examination in that various forms. Now it is all about the chapter. Additional question can be also done by the student, but as far as right now we are completing the NCERT folder first, and then we will do certain additional question also. First we will give the priority to the NCERT and the question which can be framed after every lecture. So do your homework in a regular interval, because it is related to your attendance. At a proper submission date, you have to submit your homework. And now in this video, our chapter Federalism is completed in the form of notes, plus in the form of explanation, and in the form of NCERT questions. Even after every video, we have done some extra question also, which are related to the video. So NCERT question, all folder of the NCERT has completed of the chapter Federalism. Thank you. God bless you.